Villa, and he's going to talk about probably Liouville approach and Liouville gravity, well, whatever. Liouville gravity and Villa's approach, let's put it this way, so please go ahead.
С другой стороны, да.
The subject of my talk is two-dimensional quantum gravity. It's based on the joint paper with Alexander Zamolodch. All of us, we know that there doesn't exist Einstein gravity in two dimensions, but nevertheless, if we understand two-dimensional quantum gravity as quantum dynamics of geometry, it does exist, and in fact, this quantum gravity, two-dimensional gravity, is a kind of Sakharov gravity, who considered the gravity which can be induced by matter. And there exist two approaches to two-dimensional gravity, quantum gravity. One of them is called appeared in investigation of non-critical string theory by Polyakov in the beginning of the 80s, and to ensure parameterization in variance of functional integral, which describe string amplitude, Polyakov introduce also two-dimensional Riemann matrix as one of the variables, and therefore it's in fact his functional integral is integral with respect to two-dimensional Riemann matrix so in this sense is quantum gravity, and it's called also Liouville quantum gravity, because after fixing gauge invariance is in this case is just a representation invariance, after fixing of gauge in a special way we get quantum Liouville theory, which describes metric dynamic of metric, and it's the reason why it's called Liouville. Another approach was connected. In fact, it's connected with. Is a discrete approach. It's a kind of range approach to quantum gravity, and it considers the sum when we consider the partial integral is the sum, continuous sum over whole sheet surfaces of string. And now in discrete approach we want to sum respect to discrete surfaces, and which so the idea is to simulate two-dimensional geometry by ensemble of plane graphs, and so the continuous theory will be recovered in the scalar limit, where the planar graphs of very large size dominate. And the tool for investigating of this sun, it was done. Everything was done. Now, in the middle of 80s, the tool is matrix modeling approach. Since technically the ensemble of graphs is usually generated by the perturbated expansion, fine expansion of integral over n by n Hermitian matrices. And when n sent to infinity, we get only Planck graphs, spherical topology. And so there exist two approaches, continuous one, and linear gravity and discrete matrix models. And there exist remarkable fact. Both approaches give the same, it seems that they give the same structure, the same reality. Namely, the observables in both approaches, individual gravity and its scaling limit of matrix model, have the same scale dimensions of both gravitational dimensions. Also, some correlation numbers, correlation function, but in the case of gravity, we have no coordinates, therefore it's, they are numbers, just numbers. Some of correlation numbers coincide in both approaches. And so, in the middle of the 80s, the idea, the conjecture appeared that both approach give the same things, and the correlation of numbers should coincide. But it cannot be checked, this conjecture, seriously until the recent time, because if in matrix model approach we have the answer for correlation numbers for arbitrary impact number of observables, for linear gravity we have only answers until 3.3 n equals 3 observables.
They coincided well. But up to 3 points, they coincided well.
Yes, after it was possible to reach coincidence, yes. But recently, not so recently, but 4 years ago, the 4-point correlation number was computed. It was done due to discovery of Alexei Zamolochikov, also called high equation of motion in quantum, so also classical Liouville theory, which play important role in this string theory. And after that, joint work with Alexei Zamolochikov, we get the explicit formula for 4-point correlation number, and in principle it can be done for n-point correlation number, and the answer doesn't coincide with naive answer for matrix model. In fact, I mean a very special case of matrix, namely so-called one matrix model. But there is possibility, nevertheless, to reach coincidence, but not by naive way, it's found on the so-called resonance relations. Resonance relations is such kind of relation between gravitational dimensions in this series, namely because of rationality of gravitation dimensions, there exists such identity. There exists dimensions one operator can sit inside with dimensions some another operator, and therefore there exists some choice for identification of identifications of observables in both sides. Namely, we can there is some freedom, and we can use this freedom, this resonance freedom in resonance relation to reach the coincidence for correlators also, not only for gravitational dimension.
This is all the genus zero?
What?
This is all the genus
zero? Yes. Only. So in this work we try to find exact map for special class of models. For minimal gravity, we consider so-called minimal gravity, it's special variant of Polyakov non-critical string where the play of conformal matter, the role of conformal matter, one of the minimal models of conformal field theory plays, and were exactly very special, some special series of minimal models. And from one side, it's chosen because in matrix model, you can easily consider the case of one matrix model, and which these models have big P, so-called P critical points, which is expected to coincide with this kind of minimum gravity. It appears that the problem is rather rigid. The number of parameters is in that resonance transformation is less than the number of constraints. Nevertheless, the map exists. We checked it up to level, in fact, 5, not 4, and this map does exist. I describe it later, and the explicit answer for correlation number up to level 4 also coincide, and we have a conjecture for the answer for the end point correlation. In a few words, I will say a few facts about minimal Liouville gravity. We start from this integral in respect to some matter field, which is described, the dynamic of this field described by conformal field theory, the dimensional conformal field theory, and integral over three-dimensional matrix. And we consider such object correlation numbers. These correlation numbers expectation values of observables which has the form of some density integrated by surface. When if we have defined this correlation numbers, we can define also generating functions for this for these numbers instead of correlation function correlation numbers. We can define generating functions for them as follows and introduce parameters lambda or coupling constant or times and define consider such kind partition function. You see here actual action is this term added to zero and therefore when we computed derivatives for lambda equal zero, we come back to relation numbers. So this parameter lambda can be considered as coordinates in theory space sigma. Okay, then what is definition of conformal field theory? Definition is the following: that the vacuum expectation values of trace of any combination tensor served together with other field is proportional to scalar curvature of metric. The total action for this theory, for the string theory, looks like this. It is sum of action of meta, which is some conformal field theory, because of gauge fixing action of Fanier-Popov both B and C, and action of this field P, Liouville field, which described Riemann metric, and Liouville action has this form. G hat is some background metric, and P is Liouville field, and R is curvature, scalar curvature, mu is cosmological constant, Q and P some parameters which can be chosen in such a way to ensure independence of all theory of all partition function and relation function of the method. So okay, I will skip maybe this. We can define again relation. Numbers. Then we can see that special variant when conformal meta is described by minimal model. Minimal models has some set of field, primary field, and the descendants, which is denoted like this. And we know operator product expansion in this theory in principle, and restriction fusion rules looks like this. Okay, and we will consider special series of minimal models when cut table is only of one row. In this case, we have such primary fields. Which will hold just k, like this, and we have the following fusion rules. As usual, in correlation functions, in conformal field theory, in conformal field theory, where the field are addressed by Liouville operators, they satisfy the following. Relation. One point correlation function should be equal zero. It is equal zero. Two-point relation function is equal is diagonal. A three-point relation function and n-point relation function satisfy the sum to some relation. I have to speak faster. Again, we as I told, we can define generating function also instead of relation numbers itself. And by definition, relation numbers are just derivatives of this. And okay. And up to relation up to n equal 4, we know it's this. Now, a matrix model approach, it was the result in the middle of the 80s. We can see the integral with respect to n by n emitting matrix. N is devised to sort out topologies, and when we consider n goes to infinity, we keep on the planar. And we are interested in plan answer. And the answer for scaling limit for a single part of partition function, which is nothing but partition function, which is nothing but generating function for correlation numbers, the answer is the following. We have a string equation. It's a string equation. String equation is just, this is just polynomials in respect to letter U. And coefficients of polynomial t0, t1, and so on, tk. These parameters are describing the relevant deviation from the p-critical point. And partition function itself, we get by this expression. Okay, now if we start, so it's the explicit answer. It was obtained by Gross, Midal, other people. Now we can compute relation numbers using this formula again. And here if you answer, 1 point relation numbers, is equal this, and you see that it is not equal. It is not equal zero, like it was in Liouville on Liouville side. Two point also not diagonal and. Three and more point relation function do not satisfy to fusion rules. What to do? But we have resonance here, a possibility for resonance transformation because of this coincidence. Says you see the dimension. It's easy to understand from the definition that we can describe. Dimensions to these variables. It is equivalent to observables. And we have such relation. Therefore, before identification, we have to choose a special way of identification. We have to express tk in terms of lambda k. There are some requirements. First of all, it should be analytic. It should respect dimensions, and it should be up to now there exists some family, finite number of parameters of this in this transformation. But we try. We will try to fix them. To fix them in such a way that new defined relation numbers satisfy to these properties. 1 point after differentiation by already lambda, not t, no, previous coupling constant will be equals zero, diagonal, away fusion rules, and also the same should be correct for endpoint correlation numbers. And it's, we can see that starting from n equal 0, 4, not enough parameters. And I will skip all this. Description how to do it. The result. Doing this, they're looking at this. We can look for this. Suitable resonance transformation step by step. And we can find it in the first order for one-point correlation function, and second order for two-point correlation function, and so on. And the answer is remarkably simple. We do it up to level 5. After tedious computations, we get very simple answer that in new variable, let me explain the denotation. After plugging this formula TK in terms of lambda, we get our polynomial of U becomes also polynomial of, now not of T like it was, but of lambda. And coefficients for lambda k is pk, because this is denoted. Like this is also, they are also polynomial in respect to variable U, this variable U. And the answer, it's very simple, like say this polynomial for third order is for first order is Legendre polynomial, for first order is derivatives of Legendre polynomial, for the second order second derivatives, and so on. So we arrive for fourth is third derivative. Here is the notation is the following. Lambda is Legendre polynomial of x of this order. It this means that this is a derivative of third order. And so we arrive to the conjecture that nth order polynomial is derivative. Derivative of Legendre polynomial, and therefore, if we choose very special resonance transformation and new variables, it's not lambda s, but it's the same. Is lambda k, yeah, k1, lambda kn. In this, co is the same. It was noted by P. In new variables, the answer is the following. We should consider this string polynomial, which is really polynomial of U, a polynomial of this coupling constant sk or lambda k. These are Legendre derivatives of Legendre polynomials of n minus 1 order derivative of this order Legendre polynomial. And then we should take integral up to solution of string equation. It's limit. And then we get partition function z, which is also generated function which give which derivatives give us correlation numbers for one matrix model. For one matrix model, and the second conjecture is that they coincide. This formula give us the answer also for generating function of correlation numbers in minimal Liouville gravity, in minimal string theory. So it's explicit formula, and the second conjecture was checked up to four point correlation function, just because up to now we have no answer for this. So that will be the sense. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Questions?
The summation of n from 0 to infinity, or what?
No, it ends when p minus this sum minus this becomes negative.
Partially terminated.
This transformation, is that something you understand in terms of the integral structure on the matrix model side, like the KDV hierarchy or something? Or do you understand the
That's a good lesson about higher rank matrix models, to be able to compare them with continuous series. You may have much more complicated things. But on the other hand, what's your message? There's nothing bad. Matrix models are okay in their own right? It's just the problem of sort of... matrix models are okay as they are.
Yeah.
Just the problem of the comparison between matrix models and continuous.
Yeah, but...
It's entirely unclear. As you were showing.
The question: matrix model is okay, but we can change variables in matrix model from linear variables to conformal frame in such way to reach inside.
But you have to work a lot to arrive at that transformation. It's not always a goal.
It should be proved. It's conjecture.
You discussed both the correlation numbers and the correlation functions, right?
We discuss correlation numbers because
correlation functions, which just correlation functions of local correlation.
Not the functions, numbers.
Not the functions because it is the correct observables, some local operator. Which is integrated over the surface. Because
I understand it's invariant. These correlation numbers are the invariant.
Yeah.
Correlation numbers are maybe it's covariant objects, so maybe they also have some meaning, no? That's a question.
The question is what are physical observables in two-dimensional gravity?
Yes.
The answer is that these integrated one-one form in respect almost all physical, as I understand, observables.
Very last question.
What is supersymmetric analog? What counterpart of supersymmetric will be? What is right path?
It's an open question. What is matrix? What is matrix counterpart?
I'm asking this question.
In fact, in matrix, but it seems to me that the answer is open. Is there a question?
So I'm afraid we do have to cut here. So thank you very much again. Thank you.